when we do history research, we want to be able to explain something that's analytically interesting about the past. And we want to do so using empirical evidence, empirical sources. Historians usually like to find sources that have never been looked at, maybe because they were in some obscure part of an archive and nobody really paid attention to them, or sources that maybe people have looked at, but they've just not looked at in those contexts before. Historians like to find new interpretations for interesting questions about the past. Some of the obvious questions about 20th century history have been asked, and it's hard to find new ones sometimes. The origins of World War I, the origins of World War II, you know, questions like that. But even for questions like that, you can often find new angles, new sources that haven't been considered in that context. Often historians like to find two separate themes that we've always thought were separate themes, but show that actually they were pretty well related to each other. So for example, a really wonderful book from 25 years ago, Chris Waters has a book called British Socialists and the Politics of Popular Culture. And there were historians who wrote about mass culture and the emergence of mass society, and there were historians who wrote about socialism history. And then Chris Waters comes along and says, you know, these topics actually are deeply related to each other, and writes a book that shows how these two things that people hadn't really thought about as being part of the same question actually were part of the same question. So again, it's trying to find some way to explain something interesting about the past using empirical information, using archival data, and finding new interpretations.